Hello, everybody.
Give me just a moment to finish this.
There is a fine line between genius and madness.
Alright, everybody, hello there. This is Aaron with YouTube. And I'm doing the announcing tonight for the West Coast race. So, it looks. Let me see, I lost my screen, it has all the information on it. That might be my fault, Will. I'm quite tired, so I'm not talking as loud as I should. Does this help? If I talk really loud, I can hear myself through Discord, through Trav's Loop, which, you know, is also a thing. Getting ready. Let's see. So I haven't figured out exactly who we don't have on the stream yet. It looks like dude's name. That's great. So again, welcome everybody. This is West Coast Race number 20. Is it 22? I think that would be optimal for me. And we are underway. There might be some lag for a few of the people, so don't worry if somebody seems to be behind. That may or may not mean anything. I'm not going to be able to, with the amount of different people running, keep track of every little thing that happens, but I will try to point out anything interesting. Again, Schmitty is using a slightly modded version of the ROM, which is, as far as I know, okay. React got a bag. Hippie got a bag, and Trav got a bag, so we got three of them going in. That's always a nice advantage, kind of helps to confirm that you're going to get that attack four. It doesn't guarantee it, but it helps. And that can mean a lot in a short race like this. Some runners won't even bother, they'll just go straight attack three and not worry about it. You'll see Trav do that. If he doesn't get the bag, he'll just blitz through. I'll be just fine. I'm also going to open up, I won't have it on stream because I'm not controlling the stream, but I'm going to try to grab a hold of our runners who are not, oops, that's loud, who are not currently on, because unfortunately you can only show so many people, but we also have, I believe Chroma is not on stream, and who else are we missing? Chosen are both not on stream, so I'll try to keep everyone abreast of what's going on with them as well. Anything interesting happens on their end. Once all the ads stop playing. So, who will be the first one into P1? No, actually, if depending on the lag, it might have been Chroma. It's a little hard to tell because, again, the streams I'm watching directly are going to be slightly faster for me, so they might appear to be a little bit ahead, and I'll try to manage that as I'm going along to not learn anything too much. But for those of you who are not familiar, I assume most people here have seen plenty of West Coast races, but if you're not, the general strategy is you're doing everything like we do in all keys, so you have to get all of the keys. You have to run it more or less like you're doing an all keys 100% race, with the exception that the race ends once you place the gem in P3. Which means you might see a few death abuses here and there. You might see some wonky leveling, as you do not have to aim for the 8-8-6 at the end of the game. So there will be times where people will be disincentivized from going out of their way for experience, especially if they get bad luck here in P1 or before. Straightforward so far. I haven't seen any deaths, I believe. We've just been kind of rolling along at a nice steady pace. That's always good to see. So, hello chat. I see some familiar names. It's nice that the same people tend to come around for these two. It gives you a sense that there's actual interest in the races, which is good. There's definitely interest from the people involved. I believe 8 people is the most we've had for one of these, or at least the most we've attempted to do like this, and that might be because after this we'd be attempting a horse head percent run up to or more. I don't know how many I'm gonna try to do, but that is essentially start the game and kill horse head as quickly as possible. On that note, we have, I think, the top 4 people on the leaderboard for that category here in Dude, Hippie, Trav, and Schmitty. So that could be a very fun competition to watch, but very quick too. The world record is 3 minutes and 21 seconds, so that run would already be done. All right, just kind of updating on what everyone's doing. I see Mars going for the warrior fairy, not taking any risks here. He must have done something slightly different, I think, with his leveling. I again, some people take slightly different paths, and I haven't been able to keep up on all of them, so forgive me if I'm missing anything. If I had to guess right now about who is in the lead, I would say it's probably Chosen, who's not on screen right now. But he's also a level behind, so then that might be somewhere between Chroma and Dude, who seem to be... And I'm saying all this, and then I see that React's actually ahead of him on screen, so I might be completely wrong. It's a little difficult to tell because of the experience gains and so on that tend to throw people off. But just seeing where people are, like right now, if React's right on pace with his experience, Dude is... looks like he's going for an interesting change here. Already taking life too. That's not the normal 4-1-1 completion, so he might be trying something a little out of the norm here, which we've seen a lot more recently, people being very aggressive and breaking out of the all-keys leveling pattern. Trav in particular tends to just YOLO at some point if things aren't going his way. But Trav is also on point with his experience right now. Right here at this skeleton with React, just got that bag. That's the key part here. That changes a lot of strategies for people if they don't get that. Oh, look at Chosen, he's at 212 as well, so it looks like... No, Hippie has won a number of these races. I actually have the entire Season 2 standings in front of me. I won't... There's too much going on to bore everybody with that, but I believe Hippie is one of 4 people who have actually won a race this season. He is 3, in fact. So definitely a threat in this one, and he's done really well on all of the races he's competed in. Yeah, I see. It looks like Chroma got some bad bag luck, so he'll be leaving at 3-1-1. He stuck ahead of Chosen there. Chosen didn't try, I think, so he looks like he's leaving at 3-1-2. Dude's off that too. React has the 4-1-1, which is great. That's the optimal speed strat, but if the luck doesn't come, it's often better to try something else. So, yeah, Trav's not going to get the attack 4. Hippie should, assuming he wants it. I think he can level a little bit differently too. But... And Schmitty's on pace as well. So, this is looking good. It'd be interesting to see the people with Attack 4 to see if they are able to build a lead or if it really matters at all. Again, since people have been practicing this, we've seen a lot of people. I can't. Watching Schmitty with the modded ROM there with the Link smiling face and the little dance. It's hard to keep a straight face. Oh gosh. So yes, moving right along. Again, the difference in leveling may become a factor, but it looks like we're all heading out to Jump Cave. Some people have already got the trophy, I think. I didn't miss if anyone did. Marzipan looks like right on pace, but they actually skipped the magic container at the beginning, so might have to go back and get that. Or does have to go back and get that at some point, so that'll be a sequence break in what we're seeing right now. Mm-hmm. And there's a lot of people in Jump Town now. Schmitty's got the trophy. Schmitty went for the bag outside because he didn't get the he didn't get the pea bag in the magic cave, so he went and got the one out of the forest, which put him back. I think it's about 15 seconds. That might be too much. But that guaranteed attack 4, so for him that might be worth it. If he hasn't done as many of these races, so he's probably not as keyed in on those low attack runs through Jump Cave and beyond. And that looks like that's where we're going now. Riak is out. I see Chroma is out of the town. Dude and Chozo heading that way. And Jump Cave can be a bit annoying. It's not too difficult, but poorly timed Guria boomerang can be really frustrating. And that's really it. That or you mess up I forget what they're called. The Ache Man? The Fire Bat? And get hit by that guy, because that can interfere afterwards. Really what happens after Jump Cave, that can decide a lot of things. Seeing how many encounters people get. This run only has so many areas where encounters are something that aren't completely manipulated. And right out of Jump Cave, here it is. So we'll see what sort of luck Riak gets. Looks like he's got it, so unless he makes a mistake here, he should get the Bagu with no encounters. Dude looks to be about the exact same. That's awesome. Chroma got one, and so that's gonna put him back a little bit. Again, pardon me, I am commentating a little bit for people who are not on the screen. I don't want to get too much into that because it'll be distracting, but I'll keep up. Chosen did not get an encounter, so he and Chroma got two. Well, actually, he got three, so he took a bit of a hit on time. And Trav got one here. Is Hippie gonna? Nope, I think he got out of it good. So, Hippie doesn't look like he's gonna lose any time either. Almost got the Bagu skip. The encounter, that was so close. Alright, and then, and part of the reason why this is exciting too is that right after this, you're going into Saria, where there's about a 2-minute sequence of running around, grabbing things, magic refills, stuff like that that's not terribly exciting. So. Oh, I can tell you, I saw our first death. Chroma had some bad luck on the bridge going towards Saria and took a death, so that'll put him back a little bit. But there are some death abuses in this, but none of them are particularly major, so it may or may not matter. It's more probably the time loss in the bridge itself that's going to hurt, because it is a long screen going through the whole thing, and if he died towards the end, that's, you know, in 10 seconds or so, just give up. In races like this, you can't give up too much time and be competitive. Now, on that note, I should mention that Chromaticlism actually has the most wins out of everybody this season, with 9. He has 9 first places, 4 second places, and 2 third places, with 2 did not finishes. So he has been very aggressive and very successful in this particular category. I should also mention, too, that our host, Trav White, I believe, is really pushing for a win. Surprisingly, doesn't have any. In fact, when we tallied these up, I think we were all a little bit surprised to see that he had won a race, because he's been very good at a number of these. But if he's hanging around, I wouldn't be surprised to see him do something very aggressive towards the end to try to pull one out. All right, now we're heading over to Death Mountain, and in the All Keys race, this is kind of considered to be a sleepy part where the enemies aren't particularly complicated. If you're at attack 4, this isn't much of a challenge for a speedrunner, and it tends to be a little bit of a just kind of a cakewalk. But you'll see some people with lower levels in here, and just trying to shave a little bit of time here and there, you might see some interesting strats. That, and some people are not going to need much of the experience that's in here due to this or that, so they might start skipping little things here and there. In fact, you can skip a number of the Dairas and the Gorillas in this place if you want to. Most people won't because of the experience and their relatively... Oh, man. Sorry, I just hippie hit that squid there about 3 times. She got hooked up for a little bit. Made it past now, but that's unfortunate, a little surprising. You can see Schmitty is actually, now he's back into that screen. So that time loss from earlier, I believe he did not get any encounters the way Bagu too, and that's helped him to catch up quite a bit. Or at least to what, you know, I would consider to be the main pack right now, where people were very tightly contested. Looks like Dude might have the lead right now. React is right behind him, at least from what we can see on screen. I don't have their personal timers up, so there might be some slight variance again with streaming lag and the fact that I'm, you know, watching somebody else. So there's all that possibility that can make this confusing. Let's just see how everybody else is doing. Did Hippie take a... No, Hippie cast life. That's what happened there. Okay, I just noticed he got a hit point refill. Schmitty's about a screen and a half behind him. Trav is just ahead of Schmitty right now. I didn't see what happened with him, but it looks like he's taking a bit of a time loss too. And he's getting beat up by the aches there. Not too bad. But Life too, they still do a decent amount of damage, so you'd rather get hit by them than anything else. React and Dude are basically right on top of each other right there. Dude was so close to that screen when that transition scared me a little bit. Last thing any of us want to see here is a soft lock, and inside of these areas it can be pretty easy to do it without thinking. Let's see. I think with Schmitty going in, and then we have Trav just a little bit behind him. That makes 7 of our 8 racers inside of Hammer Cave, the actual final part there. Thank you for the good luck, Vaughn. I assume you were directing that to me as well. React got out of Hammer Cave. Got out of a hammer screen a lot faster than Dude, but had to wait on that meter a little bit longer and kind of evened it back up. I see off-screen Chosen and Hippie get the hammer at basically the same time. I did not kill the Gorilla, that's true. Let's see, Chroma looks like he is basically tied with Schmitty right now, so if we're looking at sort of pacing, it looks like it's like React and Dude right at the front. Hippie and Chosen kind of third and fourth, and then Schmitty and Chroma really tight as well, with Trav right behind them. Actually, I think Schmitty took a little bit of the lead there. Chroma had some trouble with the red Dyra, so it's all within about 5 seconds at the end. There are a total of 8 racers on. Chosen and Chroma are not on screen, so I'm giving little bits of updates here and there. Trying to focus too much on them though, because I don't want people to abandon this stream to go watch them, you know. I think this was more of a first come, first serve thing. And at some point, we might. I think Schmitty even was talking about making an 8-tile stream. That 9 probably works better. Too many racers we couldn't join. Hey, it's the race after this that's that I think we got all these people here for. Yeah, so who knows? I'm sure we'll see every one of these people be here for the race after this as well. And I might join. Trav said he's going to do comms if I join, so I might just go not, because I want to see him do it instead. Alright, Marzipan with a hammer, so everyone is sufficiently hammered for the rest of this race. So yeah, this looks like React's got a few seconds on Dude now. He's, yeah, he's got about half of the screen. They're both, making short work of these enemies. Let's see if either one of them takes a death warp. React does not. And Dude does not. They both have full magic, and that's kind of the big reason to take it in Medicine Cave, is to get that magic refill, because it saves time in, you get the death warp, which is nice, but then you also save time in, Mido not having to get a magic refill to cast jump. Stalfos despawn. Yeah, I mean, well, I don't know, World Record doesn't have the Stalfos despawn, so. I got that earlier in practice, but it was after dying twice, so. I don't know if that counts as a time save. Looks like Chosen got her medicine slightly before Hippie. We'll see, is anyone gonna take? No, he's not taking the death warp either, even though he has a magic deficit. That's interesting. I would have expected that one there. Looks like Schmitty is, again, solidly in 5th, Chroma is about a screen behind, and Trav is about, I'd say, half of a screen behind him, so. And Schmitty takes the death warp. He apparently died somewhere else, too. I must have missed that. That might explain, he must have died in P1, because that would explain how he kind of got pulled back. I know he didn't lose all the time he did early, just on the, that, getting that 50 key bag in the forest. I'm aware of some other peculiarities of how Schmitty runs this, but we won't really get to see it because it mostly deals with in the, what you would do in P3 and then P4 with magic leveling. He takes an extra life level instead of the magic for an extra refill, which I get why he does it and haven't really considered it myself, but it just depends. You don't really need magic in P3 that much. Got an encounter too. The encounters leaving Medicine Cave are usually less damaging because you generally only going to get one at the most, whereas like if you mess them up in Jump Cave early, you're going to get at least two, and almost always you end up getting a third, and it's just a huge time drain. So it looks like Dude pulled ahead of React in town. He must have missed the encounter or something compared to him, so the lead has changed again ever so slightly. Marzipan with the death warp. I'm a big fan of the death warp. I don't know if you've realized that yet, chat, but the death warp, I like it. There's any time you're taking a death abuse in this run that you wouldn't take in all keys, it makes me happy. Because that means this category is actually being drilled into a little bit. We see Trav getting downstabbed, the lesser of the two stabs, but it's just a little too far out of the way to get upstab. I wouldn't mind if it was required, but then you'd have to leave P3, go all the way to get it, and then come back. And while it's valuable, it's probably not that valuable. Alright, let's watch Dude and React and see if they're able to get into P2 safely. The walk into P2 seems to be a little bit more easily manipulable than I thought at first, because I've seen a lot of people get there with very few encounters. Dude got it. 0 encounter walk there. And same for React. So I think React took one less step. So he saved, you know, maybe half of a second. But that's all the difference there is right now. Let's see where everybody else is. Hippie and Schmitty are very close right now. It looks like... And there's another difference between the ROM that Schmitty is using and the regular game is that he's renamed the pee bags as with the letter D. And that's all I will say on this family-friendly channel. I thought dude did something in the swamp that actually ate up another step, I think, that React didn't do. Or maybe he paused for a minute. I don't know. It seemed like React caught up slightly, though. Oh! Schmitty got a random fairy walk that kind of messes that up. But Hippie got caught from behind there anyway. If Trav can get a clean walk out of P2, this could be almost even. In other news, Chroma is basically with the others, dodging enemies in the swamp and getting caught, unfortunately. Trav took the encounter on the road, that's half encounter, that's if you're gonna take one, that's where you wanna do it. Is he gonna make it the rest of the way? I think he's gonna try. Nah, he didn't. It's really hard just to step count those enemies tend to appear, so. Yeah, so Trav still caught up a little bit through that swamp walk, just getting 1.5 encounters. I think both Schmitty and Hippie hit double digits. Excuse me. Like, I think they both had 2 full ones or 3. They got hit pretty hard there. So, and just as an update again, Chroma, right, or excuse me, Chosen is, he just got the key past the 2 Stalfoses, so he has a bit of separation between 4th place right now, but he's not quite on par with where React and Dude are. So he's kind of hovering in 3rd place, just a nice separation. And yeah, React can skip everything now, and that could help him, but I don't know how hard Dude is trying. It looks like he's got enough experience, he's probably going to try to get the attack 6. If he wasn't, I think he'd be skipping a lot more stuff already. So that might help. We also might see a death warp here on the glove. That's another common one that you see on this. Excuse me. I think Dude is just going to skip everything. It's a little hard to tell where he was, but now he's killing these enemies, so I think he's trying for that experience. He didn't just go straight fairy and ignore it, which he could have done. It would have actually saved a little bit of time. So he took the death warp, React did not, and that helps to maintain Dude's lead. He was going to lose the lead in that race without, or excuse me, in that room without the death warp. And Dude lost a little bit of time on the blocks. He just had to climb a little bit. Nothing too major, but everything at this point is going to be real tight. And again, I should mention that there is lag involved, so it is possible that where I am saying these people are is not where they are. Alright. It looks like everyone got out of the bot lava room fine. I didn't see any deaths through there. I lost track of what if Chroma and Chosen got through them. But they're both past it easily right now. Yeah, it certainly looks like React's just catching up ever so slightly right now. He's just being able to just burn past everything. React did that Chewy room pretty much optimally until he had to skip the leveling menu screen. That's the only thing that keeps him from being in the lead right now. It just, he didn't get it quite optimally there, so it slowed him down just a little bit. That's just everything that is right now. Anyway, let's see where everybody else is. It looks like Hippie, yeah, he's already got the glove. He's moved on. Trav has caught up completely to what him and Schmitty are. Is he? No, he's not going for the Death Warp there. I don't think he's taken him. Schmitty's not really in a situation where he can afford it. But it looks like Trav has snuck past, so he is now. And seeing where Chroma is, Chroma just got the glove, so right now Trav has moved up from 7th to 5th, and he's definitely moving up. He's skipping everything, too. When he didn't get attack 4 out of P1, he just abandoned that strategy entirely. It will slow him down a little bit. It's not too bad. And there we are. React skirted past Dude because of the leveling. Got through Helmet Head real quick. Missed the key. But we'll be leaving P2 in the lead. Now let's see. Will React attempt to do the... trying to think of what it's called now. The fanfare skip. Nah, it doesn't look like he's trying for it. Yeah, he isn't quite far enough along. It's a very dangerous thing to try, but Dude got the encounter. React got the full encounter. The whole race could be decided by the post P2 walk. Because it's the hardest thing to manipulate, I think, out of all the early game walks. And it looks like Dude got the best of that by quite a bit. Oh, Hippie took a bit of a rough death there. The hammer on the Chewy there can be pretty difficult. Oh, and Trav just went ahead and he was going for the Chewy skip, I think, but something about the movement or something there goofed up on him. And Marzipan taking a death as well. Yeah, Dude did definitely gain a leg up on React right now with the encounters. And just all it is one encounter, and that can mean everything. So, Chosen is escaped P2 as well, had a very good walk out. He is walking into Shield Town as we speak. He's still quite a ways behind our leaders, but he gained some time there. Hippie is the fourth to take out Horsehead, Schmitty right behind, and then Trav is there as well. Chroma is just getting to... I'm saying Horsehead, excuse me, Helmethead. Chroma is also the first person I've ever seen attempt the Helmet Head percent run, where all you do is go straight at Helmet Head. I think I put him up to that. You did not finish a run, though, so there's still no actual run for that. Playing it a bit safe. They're taking a half encounter. They lost some time in the manner of doing it. But he's going to go pretty aggressively here at this point, I think. When you're down that attack level, there's very little reason not to just hit the gas. So Dude is in P3. React is in P3. Like Chosen is visiting Impa at King's Tomb. Oh, Mars taking another death. This one is gonna be rough. And it looks like his leveling is gonna be off, so we won't see an attack 6 out of this either, unfortunate. But he's used to some of these different levelings. Okay, I was hoping he was gonna cast Life. I got a little bit scared. Sometimes you forget about that in the heat of the moment, because it's not planned and you think the bosses are just gonna, you know, waltz over them, and then that happens. So. And Chosen is now into P3 as well. Looks like everyone else is more or less in the houses getting the magic and getting that shield spell that everyone likes to put off till the absolute last moment. Could they probably grab shield on the way to fight I almost said Ganon. Fight Thunderbird and fight Darkwing. Oof. I thought Mars was gonna skip that encounter. Got close. Alright. exit. Yeah, it looks like Schmitty and Trav got the better of that. So that's what we're looking at in 4th and 5th place. Chroma is a little bit behind Hippie then. So that's kind of our race. We got a race for 1st and 2nd. And then we got everybody else kind of in a line after Chosen. Chosen's kind of on an island right now. He's separated himself from the rest of the pack, but hasn't been able to keep up with the action group, which is definitely understandable. Both of them have had a very good race. There's not much that you could say has went wrong for either of them. So, we should mention, we were talking about standings and so on. Dude has actually raced in one Season 2 race so far, so it's a little bit hard to use that as much of a gauge, but the one race he did, he actually lost the Chroma, which, again, Chroma has dominated these races for the most part, either due to the this or that, but he's just won a lot of them. So seeing him kind of where he is a little bit surprising, but not really, because the talent in this race is extremely good. I am not terribly sad that I'm missing this one. I would love to see all of these guys destroy me in the race. So let's see where we are. Looks like sorry, I just groaned there. Trav's having some trouble with that room. That is, dude forgot a key? Oh, you know he's done that before, too. That was actually I'm talking about this. That was the race that he had done before. He tried to go down and went down and realized that he didn't have the key and had to go back. It is the exact same thing, I think. So that sucks. But he still got a little bit of a lead there. That was some time lost, but it wasn't a major one. And if he can maintain what he's doing right now, he's still walking into a victory here. He's still got the lead. Thank you for pointing that out. By the way, Vaughn, I'm a little distracted. Let's see how Rebo goes. I think dude is definitely going to aggro. He's going full after him. Again, you do enough any percent, you're pretty much just going to go that way anyway. And you got Rebo down with the sword sticking out. React's going for the corner strat, the jackhammer. And that didn't pay off for him. He died. Now, his result is probably going to be the same either way, but the dude has finished with a final time of 35:12. React again is setting up for the jackhammer in the corner. It's a safe strat, and it's often the fast strat if you can get it done correctly. Dude is moving on. I think he likes what's going on right now and wants to keep going with it. Or maybe he's just killing time. Wants to see how far he can get before the race ends. GG's to React. 35:38. Yeah, and he noticed it too in the chat. He pointed out he was only a few seconds behind if he would have taken that death. So Schmitty gets the key in the worst trim in the game. Trav is just a little bit behind, and Hippie is right on his tail. So those three are all right there. And just for kicks, Chroma is also in the same room. So those four are going to go all the way down the end, but not for Chosen. Chosen will be done here in just a moment, yes. And he has finished now with a time of 36:22. So GG's to Chosen. Very solid run. You know, I'd be tempted to see, 36:22. I got confused. I'm a little bit curious to see what sort of, like, PB time he has, because I think that's not far off. I don't have him, like, written out in front of me or anything, but, yes, that is Chosen's best time in West Coast races. You are very welcome. Previous was a 36:49, so that's a pretty big PB. Now we're watching 4th through 7th right now, all basically on top of each other. Hippie is slightly behind. Schmitty looks like he's got it. He took care of Rebo in proper fashion and stuff. I see on the other screen, Chroma has just killed Rebo as well. We have Hippie, and Hippie's still dedicated to that corner strat. And Trav got him down too. Oh gosh, which one of them will get it? I have a feeling it's gonna be Hippy just because Trav is the local strain. We'll see here. Yep, he got him. So the full run here. Schmitty finished with a 37-17, Chromo with a 37-22, Hippy with a 37-32, and Trav with a 37-35. Just all in a row. And that's how it was this entire race, guys. You four were just trading places nonstop back and forth. At the beginning, it was a little bit more iffy, but Chosen kind of separated himself from you guys up a little bit. See, this is also Schmitty's best time, but this is only the third race he's done, so it's not anything super amazing. And it is also Hippie's. No, no, it's not. That's right, he's got a 36. I forgot about that. So, still, good times by everyone. Very good race. And now we'll focus our attention on Mars here, who's in the Minecraft room. Room named after the Mojang game Minecraft. He is... Oh, he was just going after that thing to get rid of it. I've been watching too much Rando, and I know that there's stuff else after there's Rando, and for some reason that popped into my head. Dude is still going. Hippy has transitioned into looks like any percent practice. Schmitty's having some fun with the link pose, and I think everyone else is just kind of chilling at this point to see what's happening. Yeah, I think Dude liked his pace and just wants to keep going, but we'll see, if he's committed to that or not. You might just see how it goes. I don't think I would throw a 71 potential pace run for a horsehead race, but you never know. It is pretty exciting, so. Let me see something while I'm talking about it. Yeah, no, he's not on that world record pace at all. I said 71 and 73. He's on an extremely good pace, but I think he's about 40 seconds off if his own splits mean anything. So. And Mar is taking out Revo. Sorry, I got distracted by something and paid off a little bit. Yeah, he took the death abuses. I think he's just kind of seeing how it goes. It's possible some of those death abuses might be more valuable than what you do in P4. Because P4 is just kind of unloading them because they're there. Hippie's doing any percent practice with the new routes and everything, which are just completely crazy. You sit there, you kill a Mew, you get a magic jar. You messed that up at the end. So, GG's to Marzipan with a time of 40.08. So, that is awesome.
Yo, Aaron, what's up?
Hey, Trav.
Man, what a race that was.
Yes, that was tight the entire way. Oh, how many times you guys switched places?
That was crazy. Well, are you going to join us for some horsehead?
If you're going to bow out, then I'm not going to join because I want to see you guys do this.
All right.
I want to be a witness.
Well, in that case, we're going to fire it up. Are you going to continue to do comms for us?
Absolutely.
Oh, man, I appreciate it so much, man. Give us a few minutes and we'll set that up.
Absolutely.
All right, man. Thank you.
Can you leave me on while you do that?
Yeah.
Okay. I can fill time by sharing embarrassing stories.
Sounds good. And don't forget to talk about bagels, man.
Bagels. Uh-oh. Schmitty's got it up. Absolutely amazing.
All right, y'all. Give us a few minutes. We'll be right back.
Also, thank you for the GG. Schmitty is hyped for this. I think everybody is. I mean, we'll see if Dude wants to continue or not with his run, because he's having a good run. And having a good all-keys run is difficult, but maybe he just wants to see what P4 is like without the death warps, like how much time that's going to hit him. Or with less death warps. I didn't see how many he took. Kind of, two eyes and three screens and eight different people. It's a little... A fresh everything bagel with butter. I don't know. My experience with bagels pretty much goes to the old McDonald's bagels when they got them out. I was actually working at McDonald's when they started. And so I would just make my own and just butter. Butter in a bagel, and that was it. My stream is paused because Trav White has minimized their application. Oh well. Well, I guess he's got his own stuff to set up here. Oh, you all can still hear me, right? He didn't actually cut me out somehow. If he did, I'm gonna have to go after him. Alright, good. So, again, just to kind of detail, with Dude's victory, that gives him his first victory of the season. Which puts him at one victory and one second place, because again, he hasn't been in a lot of races. React's second place puts him at a total of 5 victories, 2 second places, 1 fourth place, and 1 fifth place. Chosen in third place, that gives him a grand total of 5 victories, 3 second places, 6 third places, 3 fourth places, 2 fifth places, and 1 did not finish. Schmitty in fourth place, that puts him at 1 second, 1 third, and 1 fourth. Again, he hasn't been in a lot of races, he's just been joining us recently. Roma with, what was that, 5th place. That gives him 9 wins, 4 seconds, 2 thirds, 1 fifth, and 2 did not finishes. Another thing, everyone finished. There were no game overs. That is somewhat rare normally, but let alone in an 8-person race. It's pretty sick. So, Hippie came in 6th. Where is he on my list? That puts him at 3 wins, 4 seconds, 3 thirds, and 1 sixth place. Trav gets the first ever 7th place finish, because we never had them before. Never had that many people. And Mars with 8th. So, again, it's been a very... I think we talk about the season and something. Is that a first? First 7th place, but... Those four intermixed. At one point, Trav had gotten up to 4th. And I think just some of the stuff around P3 kind of lagged them out. Didn't get the best encounter stuff. So. No. It's not the first with no game over, but it's the... We've had game overs with 3 people and so on. So this is the first with like this many people that you wouldn't have expected us to get away with that. So. I forgot I need to actually open up the Horsehead race, so I know what's going on. Looks like everyone but Dude has joined. I don't know if that means he's not joining, or if he's just dedicated to his run, or what. I don't see his name yet. I see everybody else on here, though. So, the thing about Horsehead Percent, if you have not seen this before, this is a very short race. It is optimally about 3 minutes and 21 seconds. It is any sort of small error you make could cost you the race. This isn't like there's no ability to catch up because there is an optimal route to it. So what you're seeing here are people chasing perfection. They're trying to do everything 100% the correct way. And I mean, that can be pretty aggressive and laborsome. I think laborious is the word I'm looking for. And yes, 321 is the world record that is held by Dude. But if you look at the rest of the standings, Hippie is second with a 322.9. Trav is third with a 323.7. Schmitty is fourth with a 323.8. React here is in sixth place with a 324.6. Chroma is in seventh with 320.25. I don't know if Mars has any runs in this one. And Chosen is in a very distant 10th. It was a 3.26. It was a whopping less than 5 seconds behind. I don't see any runs for Mars, so this will be interesting too, kind of going at it fresh. But this is a category that if you do it kind of casually, it's not too bad. It doesn't go crazy. Like, you can get under 5 minutes without, you know, breaking your neck on it. But to get... I would say my time is a 3:39, by the way. I'm like 16, I'm not amazing at this. But my run is about as good as you can do with the leveling that I did. These top runners, their leveling is that they don't level. So it looks like everyone is basically ready at this point, so we're gonna start very soon. And this is just gonna be completely, I think all we're waiting now is for Trav to see if Dude wants to do this or not. And then if not, he might throw somebody else up on the string. Or he might just leave Dude up there, because, you know, he's having a really good run, so it might just be kind of fun to keep an eye on him, too. So, I'm gonna keep an eye on that. I'm gonna sneak into Dude's stream briefly. It looks like he has decided to stop. So we might see him jump in here too. Yep, there he is. So he is joining us as well. 331 or 332? You're not on the leaderboard, Mon, so I can't. I don't know. You failed to submit a run, so technically your PB doesn't exist, because if it's not on SRC, it doesn't count, right? I don't see you on there. Did you delete your account or something? Dude is ready, so now we're just waiting for Trav to start us off. And he has posted the GLHF, which is the indicator that we're starting, and now we have about 10 seconds to go. And this will be quick. You're not going to get a whole lot of interesting commentary from me. It's mostly going to be, oh, I got hit. So, and we're off. Here we go. Again, there could be some small lag issues here. So the fact that this is going to be could be such a quick race, what we're seeing on the screen might not be accurate. So it'll be interesting. Yeah, in this category, left is definitely best, because left is technically faster. And you don't have to worry about the encounter skip so much. So they're all in the dark cave. If you're doing this optimally, you will get no enemy spawn on the top, move up one, and then go straight to the palace, which is what Trav did. What is fun about this is that those of us who ran 100% NMG, or no, excuse me, New Game Plus, no major glitches recently, with the way the categories changed, there's a lot of P1 gem duping, so you go to P1 constantly. And, so that whole path and a lot of that stuff might already be in your head. And a lot of these runners have done that category, so it's all right there. Small things can change stuff over here. Getting bombed by an enemy, failing to get the key on the first attack. I've had that happen a few times. So, just small things. Mars is going for the kill. That is a very viable strategy if you're not going for, you know, world record type times, which, if you're not good at this category, if you're not really good, that's probably the best thing to do. Get yourself attack 2, get yourself life 2, maybe. The level up screens will slow you down a little bit, but it's better than dying at horse head, which is just embarrassing. The optimal strat on Horsehead also involves doing something that is very dangerous. Oh, Trav got bopped by a bot. It's the first damage I've seen that anyone's taken. And Mars takes life too, that's a good thing to do. You'll see in this route, they still need to get the key that is up here. They don't need to get both keys, because then they're going after a candle, but they do need one key. So, you see Trav grabs the key and leaves. That's all you need. You don't need to get the other one, because you're not going after the candle, so you need one less key than one. So it looks like, yeah, Mars is taking a little bit of damage, too. He's got life, too. But if anyone dies at Horsehead, that could be the difference, so... Oh, Dude took some damage there, too. That one's a hard one to skip. And you see these Stalfos fights? That's pretty much optimal, too, unless... No, the Hippie did wasn't optimal. Unfortunately. Got the Chewy skip. I'm just looking at Dude here. And Trav just knocks the guy right out of the screen. This is pretty much all world record level stuff. So let's see how the horse head fights go. Yeah, Trav is not going for the ultra optimal one, and neither is Dude. They're all just choosing to knock horse head out of the screen and deal with that delay rather than try to do the damage past him. Because the optimal strat is to take damage from horse head, run through him, and attack from the right side so you do not have to call. Alright, now we're gonna see what sort of timing differences we have going on here as everyone marches in. Yes, and Trav White has finished first with a 3 minutes and 27 seconds. Riak has a 329, Chroma has a 329, Dude has a 329, Schmitty with a 333, and Chosen with a 333. It's all these Hippie who took a death earlier, and Mars here right at the end. So that's the nature of this run. Everyone's gonna be tied up. Oh, and Hippie died too. That's, so as long as Mars doesn't game over, I almost said it right when he died. Yeah, there's, some of this might literally be when they hit the button, you know, because there could be some small differences in the start. That's how tight this is. Oh, Mars died too, so, Hippie is going back, and, let's see if Mars is gonna go. They're still got a shot, but I don't know. If you're waiting on that screen, I don't think he's got the... Probably just wants to go ahead and start back the next round. Try it again later. Yeah, Mars tried for the... he just said that in chat. Tried to go from the right side, and it didn't work out. He was the only one that did. Everybody else went left side, fought horse head normal without trying to damage clip through him. Which again, if you can do that, that's the best thing, but that's kind of difficult. So, Mars has dropped, so we're just watching Hippie here to finish. And Dude did his one, and he's out now, so he's going to bed or whatever. So we'll see. It looks like, from what I can tell, everybody else is still in. Can't tell with Hippie, although I know his time zone is very rough for these races. So seeing him stick around for too long is not common. Yes, thank you, Dude, for the race. That was awesome. It's, this race in itself is a bit of, thank you for pointing out my cough, Cheryl. My cough is because I drank too much caffeine. I always get coffee when I do that. Started coughing a lot. So apologies, I'm trying not to do that on the mic. I could just mute the mic as it comes. I'm pretty fast. Let's see if Hippie can get it done. Thank you. So again, Hippie does have the second best time in this category. A unique thing about him, if you haven't seen it or heard about that before, he plays on keyboard. So there are certain things that helps with a little bit, and there are certain things that it really does not help with. It works pretty well for button press speed, in that, I don't know if you've typed and type and so on, but you can go fairly fast on keyboard. It does very bad with things that require sensitive touches, so... he tends to avoid categories that use things like fairy feet because that's a one-frame tap involved in that, and that's very difficult on the keyboard. But things that involve certain other types of button presses tends to work out fairly well. That's not to say he has some sort of advantage, I'm just saying that's the sort of categories he gravitates to. Alright, the race is finished, Hippie in 7. I'm going to go see where the other race is open. Oh, he hasn't opened. Oh, there it is. We have another race open. I'm going to go directly to that. From what I can tell, everybody else except for Dude is in. They haven't joined the race yet. Looks like, yeah, Trav's opened it. He just hasn't joined it yet. I see Chosen, Chroma, and React all there. Looks like, I think think dude's gonna to walk it back himself. Nope, never mind. He's doing something else entirely. It looks like that's probably some any percent running. I think we know what Mars. Oh, threw a bit of a curve there. So, okay, now more people are joining. I think we needed it to be announced in Discord for the others to pick up on it. Got some advertisement going up there. Yes. Prime Day show with these people that I've never heard of. Presented by Amazon Music? I guess I've downloaded all the music that I've bought in like the recent thing from Amazon service. At least ever since Walmart closed their online one. It wasn't super great, so I get why they did that. It is funny to think about. I had Walmart MP3s. Because it's been like 8 years since they did it. Alright, it looks like everyone has joined the race room except for Trav White. I don't know what he's waiting on. Or if he's possibly sitting out too. I assume if he was, we'd already hear him on comms. It was a good race. I already forget what the order was. But it was everyone on top of each other. This category is going to be that sort of thing. In fact, this is a good preparation for the knockout tournament that is coming up, I think, next month? I think it's the end of July. I don't know. I don't think we've got it completely narrowed down yet, but I know it's coming. And these sorts of things, to know what we're going to do, like, literally going to be some frame counting. Going to be some tight stuff in some of these races, but it will be a knockout tournament if I recall right, so it's going to entirely be like everyone will race, the last couple of people get cleared out. I don't know if it'll be like a one-time thing, so if you just have one bad knock and you're done, it might not. So, let's all blame Trav, that sounds good. Yep, it looks like everyone is getting ready, we're almost there. Chroma versus Force. Oh, you're all missing out on that. It's a good title, too. Uh-oh. All right, Schmitty. we'll let you guys just kind of watch that one on your own there. So it looks like everyone is ready. We're just waiting for Trav to pull the trigger. Blame Vaughn. Let's all blame Trav. React with the RK. And we got a couple people who are just going with their normal ones here. So but we'll see. We're almost ready for Horsehead run number 2. Oh gosh. I don't want to think too much about what Shmee's title says. Oh. And. Oh, I see. Trav's going to try to throw somebody else up on stream here. There he is. So it looks like Chroma is getting some airtime today. So congratulations, Chroma. You have now made it to the restream. Poor Chosen. Chosen may not, we may not see him, but he is here in our hearts. I will let you, well, I can't really say much about what he's doing because he's going to finish at the same time as everybody else probably. I could try to micro machines guy the ending here and just, you know, like we're doing some sort of auction, but I don't quite have the skills. Anyway, here we go in 2, 1, and start. Let's see how it goes. Is anybody going to go right? Chroma goes right. Starting off a frame or two behind already. Chosen's actually going to be ahead on my screen because of I have less lag from his stream. So, 5 frames, there you go. He's giving everybody a little bit of a buffer, you know, just in case. We'll see if anything bad. Oh, trap hits the encounter. We were just talking before about how it's very manipulatable, like going straight there and getting that's really unfortunate. That could be the difference in the race. Or something like that, you know, you have to make it seem overly dramatic. But this is a very cool thing, so I wouldn't be surprised. Trav is going the wrong way. He's recovered. See, and this is the thing too, when you're doing the, New Game Plus No Major Glitches runs, you don't go get this key because you have the fairy spell. You just fairy through the doors. So that can be a bit of a distraction to kind of make you lose track of what's going on. It looks like everybody is going for the mostly pacifist route when they're killing enemies that don't give experience. If the enemy doesn't give experience, I think that means it doesn't have a soul. So it's basically like killing a plant. Unless you believe plants have souls, in which case I'm sorry, I didn't mean to offend you. Anyway, sorry, I had to marvel at my stupidity for a second. Everyone is just kind of getting through normal here. I don't see any damage yet. Mars is sticking with the strategy of killing these enemies. Probably going for attack 2 to try to make Horsehead a little bit easier. If you're not an expert Horsehead fighter, that's probably the best way to do this category. Is to get your experience, get your attack 2, and go from there. It is a slower route, but it's much safer. And we saw what happened last time with both Mars and Hippie taking a death. Now you'll notice when they grab the key, I think the optimal route there is to actually run down into it, low stab, and immediately jump. Because if you jump and hold left, it'll break down the momentum. And I think that is the fastest way to do it. So. Looks like Chroma might have the lead here. No, I think Schmitty does. Sorry, excuse me. I'm really right on top of him. So, again, lag could be a lot here. Chosen just took a death in the last room before Horsehead. So, that is really unfortunate, too. We got Schmitty and Chroma and React all in the final room here. Let's see if any of them go for. No, we're not going. I don't see any ultra aggressive strats here. Just trying to take out the horse as quickly as possible. They're doing standard attack motions, not trying for a bunch of double hits or anything silly. And React looks like he's the first one to get him down. We'll see what happens with the finish here. Now I'm having to skip levels. And should I leave everyone suspenseful? Nope. The winner is React with a 328, Hippie right behind with a 332, Schmitty with a 333, and Chroma with a 333. Maritz is finishing 5th place with a 344, and Chosen with a 347. React says it's a 3019. But you know how the timer is going and all that, so. Okay, maybe I don't know what he means by that. And we're just waiting for Traff here at the end. And Horsehead's down for him, too. Oh! Okay, I figured it out. They're posting that's a 3.019 is in the milliseconds. That doesn't show up on race time that way, so. Race is finished in 4 minutes and 20 seconds with Traff finishing up, so GG to everybody. It's exciting. You can see the sort of badness that can happen there at the end, and just a little bit of a mess up, and all of a sudden you're dumped out at the top. It was a good run by everybody. Mars did pretty much exactly what you want to do in the attack two line, the 344, which would actually be quicker on his splits, I'm pretty sure. It generally is. That's a fairly decent time for the leaderboard. And maybe I'm only saying that because it's close to my time.
Hey, Aaron, how are we doing?
Doing great. Congratulations. You hit the whole gambit there.
I went from first to last. We're wanting to know if you have one more race in you.
Oh, I'm good.
All right. Well,
I can spare another 4 minutes and 20 seconds.
Man, we really appreciate it. We'll set it up for you.
All right. You can see how random this is. Yeah, so React had ended with 019 and Shmini was 127, so they're pretty close. But again, what they show on the screen and what they actually have can be different because people's splits don't always start at the same time that they do it unless they're linked in with the race time apparatus, which I suggest. I do that when I race on race time. I think he actually just saves different ROMs for different practice segments. You know, that's something that I do too. Like, I have different versions of of Zelda 2, where I just save it and rename them for when I'm going to use so that my save states are tailored to it. So, React has been working on something for Forest Head. We joke a little bit about this, or maybe I just joke about it. React is probably the most active sciencing person for a lot of these things, really digging into stuff. Okay, that might be what he's posting up there, total frames, because I see them posting it in the chat. So that might be what that was, that 3019. Excuse me. I said that. I should actually walk that back a little bit. Hippie has been... Hippie and Eunice and Dude and Light have both. I think Light was actually the first one, and then Hippie brought something else out with the Any% route to where that's changed that run considerably, which is crazy because it's Any%. Any% in a popular game like Zelda 2 isn't supposed to change, but it hasn't been quite as popular as All Keys because it's All Keys is very glitch heavy, or excuse me. Any% is very glitch heavy, so a lot of people kind of kept away from that. But there's a lot of stuff that's happened in Zelda 2 speedrunning, so it's interesting to say the least. All right, and we're just waiting for Trav, waiting for our gatekeeper to hit the button, and then we're all ready to go. Let's see, so Trav got the first one, then React. I always joke because Trav is the mod on race time. He's not the only one, but he's the one that usually confirms the races, and the order you do them in actually impacts your points. So we'll see if he puts them done in order or if he starts to trick them around a little bit to help his score. You know, we'll see. Anyway, the race is underway. And again, don't trust that everything on the screen is necessarily correct. As far as the differences, I would go off of what you see them doing in the runs, because a bump here and there, they might look like they're still in the lead, but not necessarily the case. Or if anything, it's probably Travis probably slightly ahead of the other, since he's actually just training himself and not relying on anybody else's capture. Let's see, it looks like yeah, it looks like everyone has gotten out of encounters unless Mars catches one on the rack. Nope. Good, so we're all into P1 safe and sound. Safe as houses. Going through the soulless team suits. And just kind of running in again. You see little things here, like the box, the end of the room, on the exit. Going in, they can be a bit of a problem, but it's usually not too bad. It's leaving. Oh, React missed the key. That little thing could matter. Imagine in a knockout tournament, you're in the finals, and you're going against somebody you have to be perfect when something small like that happens, and so for the next 2 minutes, you're just like, crap, I'm behind, crap, I'm behind, crap, I'm behind. because you missed a key. That's how tight this is. It would be interesting. Someone's gonna lose on horsehead key grab. I think in the first one, that did matter. Or maybe I was looking at practice, I can't remember. But yeah, we got some of the best people in the world at this category on screen right now. And it hasn't seemed to impact the results too much. But they're all very close, and this is something that getting that perfect run just requires very precise timing. So, from the looks of it, it looks like Trap might be in the lead, but again, I haven't seen any real changes, so I kind of gotta believe they're all just right on top of each other right now. I didn't time when they all started to see if there's any differences in that, but I haven't seen any real mistake from anyone. The only thing I saw that was a difference was Marzipan took a little bit longer getting the P1 in the way that he skipped it, so Hippie killed some stuff and lost a little bit of time there, so that puts him back a little bit, but not a lot. As I say, he might just kill this Chewy now to take life too rather than dying. That's probably quicker, and yeah, that looks like that's what he did. Nope, he skipped life too. Okay. Yeah, Trav was probably first. I think Chosen might actually be ahead. It's kind of hard to tell because, like, it says I have 0.39 seconds of lag for him. So, but that is the first screen flash that I see is on Chosen's screen. Chroma right after, or React right after, and then Chroma. And, oh gosh. Yeah, there we go. Wait for just a second to see some of these finish up, and then I'll go through the whole list for everyone. So, here are our results. React is finished first with a time of 3:29. Chosen is second with a time of 3:29. Schmitty has a 3:43 and finished in third. Hippie's in fourth with a 3:51. Looks like Trav. Trav is in. Oh! Excuse me, yeah, Hippie was in fifth. I said that wrong. Chroma was in third with a 3:33. I missed Chroma somehow entirely on the list. Travis finished in sixth with a time of 4 flat. And here's Mars just leaving, it looks like, one hit on Horsehead to finish off in this one. So, yeah, I think it looks like Chosen and Chroma have the particular frame count. And according to this, Chosen actually did it faster than React. Oh, you're right, he has that up there. So, I don't... No, I do see that on Chosen's screen, too. You know, I just didn't notice that. I'm sorry. I could have mentioned it. So, it looks like Chosen actually was quicker, but hit the split later, or started slightly late. So, according to race time, React won, but Chosen actually finished it in less time. I see 3:03.6 for Chosen and a 3:05.4 for React. So, yeah. Well, you can find him at twitch.tv/chosenear4, all one word. It will be interesting to see if this is the sort of thing we use for that. I know that's been talked about. It won't necessarily work with the way race time works, but it's not much you can do about it, I guess.
Are y'all talking about the custom ROM we had made here?
Yes. I didn't notice that until the last run.
So that is made by React, and what it does is it frame counts from start, and so if we figured we would have some races that were pretty close and with race time and everything, with lag and yada yada yada, this will get us the exact frame from when you press start on the screen until the gym, until you lose control of Link. And so, if we have a bunch of racers that are pretty close, we will not have to frame count.
Nice. This is awesome.
And so, if we have races that are, you know, within frames of each other, we'll be able to get them pretty accurate. They're, to be completely honest, there is some estimating that's going on, but everyone will be estimated, so it'll be fair. For whatever reason, if someone can't run on the ROM, that's 100% okay. We can go back and frame count. Like, say you don't have a setup where you can run a custom ROM, like you don't have an EverDrive or a Power Pack or whatever, you just have the game, that's perfectly okay. We'll frame count you if it's that close and move on.
Yeah, that's like Schmitty has rated Ice Blue.
But Aaron, I want to thank you so much for your comms today, man. I really, really appreciate it. And I want to say a big thanks to all the racers. And we'll see all the viewers next Monday. I'm assuming we're still going to do a West Coast race and then move right into some Horsehead races. Try to hype up this tournament. I was told by Schmitty that we do have the official date. We're just trying to iron out some details, so anyone watching tonight can get the official date, and that is July 24th. Yes, and it will be held on Z2 Rando. I think that's what I posted in.
I think you posted ZSR.
Yes, ZSR. I'm sorry. ZSR will be hosting us. And the official date is July 24th. I don't have a time yet, but as soon as I know all of that, we'll make a flyer and all that good stuff. Send it out.
Yes, we will make the flyer, we will take it to Kinko's, we will make copies.
That is correct.
We'll see them in the mail.
Yeah. Zelda Speedruns will be hosting us, so
that makes it official.
that will be a nightmare for whoever's restreaming. I feel for them.
And it's going to be a knockout tournament, right? So we're just going to start clipping people after every round, or is it going to be like a...
Yeah, so say we have 20 racers, all 20 racers will race at the same time, and we don't have quite all the official rules, but the way a knockout tournament works is, say we have 20 racers racing, the bottom two will be out until we're left with 1v1, and then... 1v1 is best of three.
All right, that sounds pretty good to me. I think I've heard them kind of thin that out towards the end, but I guess it just depends on how many rounds you want, you know?
Yeah, I think it's really going to depend on how many racers we get. You know, I saw a Chip and Dale's one time where there was like 75 racers, so.
Right.
We're going to try to.
You probably got to figure out how many early rounds you want, and then just decide how many people are going to cut every time off of that. So, like, you want like 10 early rounds at the most. So, if you got like 40 people, you're going to want to cut like four. If you got 30 people, you're going to cut three. That sort of thing, I imagine.
Correct. We're going to try to keep it, you know, a somewhat manageable amount of time, like around 2 hours or whatever.
That sounds awesome. I will put that in my plans to ask off for work if I'm still working. and definitely, because I want to be in that. It doesn't matter. It's random. You know what? V-Trav White here could accidentally bump an Orange Knight and die or something and game over or some terribleness and be out in the first round.
Yeah, I mean, really anything can happen. It's really a crazy run, and really all of the RNG is right at the end. So.
Yeah, I just cursed you by saying that.
I mean, you know, it is what it is, Aaron. Racing's fun, and it is what it is.
Alrighty. Well, thanks again for having me. We're gonna keep this up because. You know, we're talking about 20 people. We need to get like 50 people. This is short. It's easy to learn. You don't have to do the ultra aggressive route you've seen most people do. Mars was doing a little bit slimmer route, getting some experience, and was right in competition. And again, these are some of the best people in the world at this category. So don't expect that you need to beat these people to have some fun in the tournament. And you saw what they did too.
Yep. Like,
almost everyone had one bad run.
I agree with Kelsey. Go big or go home.
Yeah.
But once again, thank you, Aaron. Thank you, all of the viewers. Y'all are amazing. Y'all are awesome. But we're going to cut it. And let's go raid somebody. Who are we going to raid tonight?
Who are we going to raid?
Yeah. Let's see. But, I will catch y'all all next week, and until then, y'all have a good one. Let's go raid cheese.
Peace.
Later, man.
Woo.
Thank you, Aaron.
Stuck it in. Dude, I'm gonna cut. That was fun.